spent all morning blowing up 8 of these balance boards. Thank God for that. Anyway, apart from that, you join me in a very early morning episode. That's a lie, it's 10:30. I've been awake since 7, so you join me for a mid-morning. Let's talk about video. And it's very raw this morning, considering that I didn't even bother to get ready for the videos as I normally do. So we're back just to the Superman pajamas and Superman dressing gown as well. So the main subject for today's video is movies coming up in 2017, and obviously, I mean, 2016 was a year for big action-packed blockbuster movies and such as well. But next year seems to be quite interesting, quite colourful. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a list last night of movies I would like to talk about and orders and blah 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 blah. But what I've just typed into Google was movies 2017, and I pretty much got everything I wanted to talk about anyway. So what I'll do is I'm just going to quickly scroll through the ones that come up here. I'm hoping that I've talked about all of them that I want to talk about. If there's one or two that I miss, then I do apologise, and I'll probably maybe talk about them in another video. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start scrolling through and just talk through the movies that I'm seeing, and obviously then the thoughts about it as well. So the first one is Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, which I mean, after the first one 2 years ago now, which really took everyone by surprise, including me as well. I'm quite thoroughly excited for this, and considering that Kurt Russell's in the movie, I think it was confirmed that he's playing the Star-Lord's dad. That's going to make it a wee bit more interesting. There was a trailer that dropped quite a while ago, and to be honest, I can't remember too much of the trailer. I need to go re-watch it again. All I know was that they had me from the start, so I was going to go and see the second movie regardless anyway. Now the next one is the Power Rangers movie as well, and oh, you all know my thoughts on that. Oh my. Costume design is maybe the only thing I had a concern about originally. Even now, I'm a wee bit, I'm not too sure. I thought they might have went for maybe like the original costumes, like the 90s, like Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. Or they might have done something newer or anything like that as well. It's just, I don't know, for me it was just a wee bit odd, and if anything, I thought they, I mean, I don't know yet, I've not seen the movie, but I thought they might have done like live action suits rather than CGI, but hey, well, that is what it is. So I am excited for the Power Rangers movie as well. Now the next two are Marvel movies. So Spider-Man Homecoming, I mean, I'm not excited, but I'm not, let's go Spider-Man. But for me, I mean, I'm always quite a traditionalist, quite an original person. I always thought that Tobey Maguire was the best Spider-Man. A lot of people say, oh no, it was Andrew Garfield. I don't know. I mean, Tom Holland did a great job in Civil War. So, you know, I'm looking forward to it. I'm not saying that, oh god, it's not a Marvel movie. What I'm saying is, okay, well, we'll see how it goes. Next one after that is Thor Ragnarok, which, I mean, again, is one that's not really, we've not really had a lot of details about it. I mean, normally you get leaks all the time, blah blah blah. We know that Hulk's in it, we know that the holiest of holies, Jeff Goldblum's in it. Straight away, he's going to make it the best Marvel movie of all the Marvel movies. So, and that'll be maybe like the 14th or 15th Marvel movie, so there we have it. So yeah, Thor Ragnarok, until we get more details, even a wee teaser or a trailer, then yep, I will be there. Now, the next one, Kong Skull Island. I don't know, again, being quite like, I say traditionalist, I prefer obviously the originals. I prefer when King Kong was not the size of the Burj Khalifa. I preferred when he was a wee bit smaller, but obviously in this day and age, and in 2020 when he takes on Godzilla, you know, there'll need to be some sort of height change there, so that's obviously why they've had to make him tall. The story doesn't seem it's going to like follow the original story, or even that of like the 2005 Peter Jackson one as well. So this will, again, it's going to be interesting. You've got a good cast. You've got John Goodman. You've got Samuel Jackson. you've got Tom Hiddleston, so it's quite a good mix. It'll be interesting to see. It will be interesting. The next one is Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales, and I think for the UK they changed the title because Dead Men was offensive or some rubbish like that, I don't care. Trailer looked alright, having Javier Bardem as the bad guy. It was obviously a great choice because he's amazing. If you've never seen Skyfall or you've never seen No Country for Old Men, then what are you doing with your life? So, Pirates of the Caribbean, it's Johnny Depp. It's a franchise that should have died out like three movies ago, but hey, we're here now. We are here now. Next one is Logan, which, again, I'm not a... to give you a quick rundown, I grew tired of the X-Men movies after Last Stand. First Class happened, I watched First Class, and I was like, oh, hey, here we go. And then it kept going and going and going. And my main issue with the X-Men franchise was it was all Wolverine. Like, this is obviously the third Wolverine movie as well, so for me, I grew tired of it because it was always Wolverine, blah, 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 blah. I would have loved to have seen the great Cyclops movie. Oh my god, Cyclops. Even Storm, Storm is quite interesting as well. So, Iceman, Angel, anyone else. But, again, as was. I like the trailer, I like the use of Johnny Cash in it, hard as well. So, give it kind of a dark tone. And also, it's a dark tone anyway to the movie. If you've seen the poster or the trailer, I think it's an R-rated one anyway. So, again, that'd be good. Right, here's one. Woohoo! Star Wars Episode 8. Now, you all know my hype for Rogue One. So you can only imagine that when it comes closer to the time for Star Wars Episode 8, this whole channel is going to be Star Wars, Star Wars, Star Wars, Star Wars Theories. Ooh, Star Wars Theories. There's another thing I could start. We will come to that. Okay, but again, not lots known. Benicio del Toro is the villain in it. Oh, that's a lie. Me being me, I'm like, oh, I always hate spoilers going into movies, but I will be the first one to read all the script leaks or the photo leaks from sets, blah, blah, blah. To be fair, the only movie I've really watched out for is Suicide Squad because of, obviously, my thoughts on a certain character, so that's the only one I'm trying not to look into too much, but Star Wars Episode 8, I'll be there. You'll be damn right in saying I'll be the first person to book IMAX tickets, like, a year before, so you know, that'll be that. Wonder Woman is the next one, and Wonder Woman, again, it's obviously DC, so I will be there again. I wouldn't say maybe go out of my way to see it first night it comes out, but I will definitely be there. And a lot of them are saying, oh, Wonder Woman could be the one that will, you know, save the DC franchise. Right, I know that obviously there's a lot of, sorry, I thought I'd taste plastic there in my mouth from all that pumping up stuff. Personally, I say it doesn't need too much saving. From the critics, maybe, but the critics are critics. The critics that went and saw Batman v Superman were more or less expecting Batman v Superman to be a Marvel movie, or expecting it to be a family-friendly thing, and it wasn't, and that's probably what made people mad. For me, I quite enjoyed Batman v Superman theatrical cut. I loved the extended edition for the extra 30 minutes of scenes that we got to see, but I liked it. I really did like it. It was what we needed. And I've not seen Suicide Squad, but I don't know, I feel like that one maybe let us down a wee bit. Not that I'm saying it. But apart from that, I don't feel like, you know, it's needing saving, and especially with some of the footage we've seen for Justice League and the Batman solo film, that Deathstroke stuff as well. Again, as well as, I'll be there. Might not be there in the opening night, but I will definitely be there. Next one on the list is Fast 8, Fast and Furious 8. I've not really watched the franchise as much anyway. I think we've got the movies, but I've just not had time to watch it, so I'll skip over that one. We're just coming into like the kind of last ones here, the last ones I really care about. The other ones are kind of, I don't know. I'll just skip over. I'm just going to go really to the ones that I really care about anyway. The next one is Justice League itself. So, And you all know the deal with the Justice League. I will be there at like Star Wars Episode 8 2 years before when they sell IMAX tickets. So no, it's obviously, I don't know actually what month it's coming out on. I think it's November, but the hype. And yeah, I will admit I'm a wee bit disheartened that Green Lantern isn't there, or Martian Manhunter isn't there. Cyborg was always one I think that kind of jumped between Teen Titans and Justice League anime, but you know, unless of course what popped in my head the other day was that they actually do have Green Lantern in it, whether it be Jon Stewart or Hal Jordan or the other one I forget about, he could actually be in the movie. Even as a cameo, or he's actually got a wee bit in the movie and he comes in like at the end or something like that, so you know, at least we have something. But again, we'll just need to wait and see. Nearly there, still got a year to go. Beauty and the Beast I'm going to skip over, Transformers Last Night I'm going to skip over, Lego Batman Movie, for all it is, DC property, I'll give it a skip over now. Alien Covenant, the poster just got released this morning. I know it's the sequel to Prometheus. Again, I'll be there, I'll go and see it in the cinema. Maybe not the first night it comes out, but I will be there. World War Z2, I didn't watch the first one. That was during that generic time of zombie movies and vampire movies, so I didn't really see it. Kingsman, I didn't actually see. I do want to see it, I just didn't see it when it came out in cinema or DVD, so I need to see it so that I can go and see that one in cinema. King Arthur, Legend of the Sword, probably not. War of the Planet of the Apes, probably yes. I've seen the other two, so I need to see how it ends. I know how it ends, shut up, Cam. Dark Tower, the Dark Tower Stephen King's one. You know what, yes, I might actually go and see that cinema. And I've got a gift card that I won 2 months ago, a £20 gift card that I won, so I suppose I'll use it. Cars 3, well, you all heard my opinions on that yesterday. And if you didn't know what, sorry, not yesterday, 2 days ago on Tuesday. If you've not seen that video, there's the video there, go and watch it. Sorry, started to slide down there. That's going to be interesting for Disney Pixar movie. Triple X, Return of Xander Cage, it's been ages since I've seen Triple X. I can only remember the storyline very fondly, but whatever for that. John Wick Chapter 2, yes, I will be there. I was really, when the first one came out, I can't say it was broadcast a lot in the cinemas where I was, so I saw it on DVD when it came out. That's actually obviously my main man Keanu. So I will be there for John Wick 2. Despicable Me 3, probably not. Well, that's a lie. I'll see it on DVD. I won't see it in cinema. Valerian and the City of a Thousand Planets, probably not in cinema, maybe on DVD. Ghost in the Shell, watch the original anime, it's probably the only anime to date that I've actually watched all the way through. Probably not, and if anything, it'll be DVD. Dunkirk, yes, because it's a Christopher Nolan movie, and it's also a war movie, so it's going to be interesting. Blade Runner 2049, maybe. 50 Shades Darker, of course. Baywatch, I will say yes, it's got Dwayne Johnson in it, and can you smell what the Rock's cooking? I can. Annabelle 2, probably not. I hate spin-offs and I hate sequels to spin-offs, so no. Jumanji, of course, Dwayne Johnson, Jack Black, forgetting the lady's name, I want to say Isla Fisher, not 100% correct, or sure if I'm correct there, and Kevin Hart as well. Again, I will see it because Dwayne Johnson, Jack Black, Kevin Hart and Isla Fisher, if I'm right in saying that's her name. Pitch Perfect 3, not a chance. The Mummy, the reboot series, we'll give it a shot, and if they mess it up, no chance. Baby Driver, no. Fist Fight, no. Trainspotting 2, I'll need to because that's a national movie, you know. It's like the Americans not watching, like, whatever, it's like Team America, you know. Smurfs, not a chance. Boss Baby, probably not a chance. Flatliners, no, so we're starting to get into, Yeah, like, oh, right, there's one I've just passed by. Emoji Movie. They're making a movie about emojis. This is why this planet is doomed. Okay. And then we've kind of come to the end. There's maybe one or two I've missed in there, but I think that is it. Yeah. Oh, and the Friday the 13th reboot as well. Not that we've got much details on that. So, apart from that, that's my really rapid thoughts about movies in 2017. If there is any I've missed, comment down below and I'll try and leave a comment just again with brief thoughts of what I'm thinking about it. As I said, I think last video or two videos ago, I'm going to try and get back into doing movie reviews, game reviews, so all the games that I do play now, you know, it's maybe not a lot, but you know, just thoughts on the games that I've had, like some of the older games as well. Movies though, movies is obviously my jam, it's where I am, so I will be there for your movie reviews. But 2017 year, it looks like a promising year, and I really hope that Wonder Woman, Justice League, you know, I hope that, obviously maybe don't do better maybe as a story, but I hope that the critics actually pull the finger out and, you know, stop thinking that everything's got to be like Marvel. And obviously this is, I will admit, it is quite a dark universe, it is what Zack Snyder's doing. I'm not saying that I'm hating it, but you know, it is a grittier universe, but you know, it feels like it could happen. That feels like what happened in Batman v Superman for, well, okay, apart from maybe the whole ending sequence could happen, possibly, maybe. But if we lived in a world where Superman was real and Batman was real, and then all the stuff that's happened in that universe we're not even 100% sure on yet happened, then yeah, I could see that happening. And, you know, it's a scary thought, but, you know, that's that. In terms of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, I mean, I could still see... maybe I don't see all of it happen. I think more maybe what the Russo brothers are doing with like the Captain America, like Winter Soldier and Civil War. Yeah, that could happen. That those people could be real, and that stuff could happen. But I don't know. This for me. Next year, the big movies. I'll scroll back through big movies I'm seeing: Wonder Woman, Justice League. Alien Covenant, and of course Star Wars Episode 8, sorry, Guardians of the Galaxy, Power Rangers, yes, and I think one of the first ones that comes out is Power Rangers anyway at the start of the year, I think it's March or February or something like that. So yes, so that's pretty much it. That's it. Sorry, I just gave me all the dates there, of what's actually coming out, when it's coming out anyway. So yeah, tell me, did I miss a movie that you're excited for coming out in 2017? What are your thoughts on some of the movies coming out in 2017? Any that I mentioned there as well? You know what to do? Comment down below. I'll try my best to reply, find that I'm not out and about or doing whatever as well. We'll be back next week with another Shermanator show, and then next Thursday another Let's Talk video as well. Don't know what it's going to be about. If you have any video actually cut out there, I do apologise. So yeah, as I was saying, if you have any ideas for like a Let's Talk video, or even, I mean, I've got a lot of plans for the Shermanator show, but if you've got any episode ideas for like this, a Let's Talk episode, then do, you know, comment down below, or, you know, leave a comment on Facebook or Twitter or even Instagram, for those of you following me on Instagram. You know, just keep it interesting, keep it on our toes, find good discussion points. Because you know me, I would just talk about all superheroes and all sci-fi and stuff like that, you know. Which is not a bad thing, because I know some of you out there might want that, but you know, if you want anything else, just comment, and you know, you don't get it if you don't ask for it. So yeah, that's that. So that's us, guys. I'm not gonna go in on any more, so you know what to do. much appreciated if you just leave a like, let me know that you're there watching, leave a comment about anything that you need comment about, you know, like if we talk about any ideas or anything like that. And always subscribe, because it's always appreciated, especially now that we're like, well, 14 episodes into the Shervinator Show. I think this is like my third or fourth Let's Talk About video. I want you to do more of these. But always, you know, much appreciated if you subscribe. Apart from that, guys, I will see you into the next week, unless anything exciting happens this weekend. Which I don't think it will. Okay. Thank you.